Hello everyone, this is Hardi and you are watching the Pharma Drill. Today, in this video session, we will be discussing Mohr's method, which is a precipitation titration method. This method is given by Carl Friedrich Mohr. In this method, endpoint is detected by formation of colored precipitates. Mohr's method is used to determine chloride and bromide. For example, NaCl, NaBr, KCl, KBr, etc. Titrant used here is standardized AgNO3 solution and indicator used here is potassium chromate, that is 5% solution. The principle of Mohr's method is when NaCl is reacted with AgNO3, the precipitate of AgCl is obtained and now indicator is added, that is K2CrO4, and it is reacted with AgNO3 to form precipitate of Ag2CrO4, which is reddish brown in color. This reaction is carried out in neutral medium. Titration of 0.1 molar NaCl by using 0.1 molar AgNO3 in presence of K2CrO4 with 5% solution. There's a term called KSP value. It is the solubility product constant. It is the equilibrium between a solid and its respective ion in the solution. The value of this KSP helps to identify the degree of which the compound can disassociate in the water. The larger the 10th power, the more soluble is the compound. Say for example, 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 is greater than 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. The KSP value of AgCl is 1.77 into 10 raised to minus 10 and KSP value of Ag2CrO4 is 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 12. AgNO3 will be added from the burette into the solution containing NaCl and indicators added. As per the KSP value, Ag2CrO4 should precipitate out first, but AgCl precipitate appears first because of concentration of Cl- ion is much more higher as compared to CrO4 2-. At this end point, all Cl- ion will react with AgNO3 and form AgCl precipitates, which is white in color and also known as primary precipitate. After that, addition of extra drop of AgNO3 will lead to reaction with CrO4- ion from indicator and it will form reddish brown precipitate of Ag2CrO4, which is also known as secondary precipitate. At the end point, reading is taken and Cl- ion concentration is detected. You might be wondering why iodide ion is not determined by this method. Because the primary precipitate formed in the iodine gives reddish brown precipitate, as well as the secondary precipitate also give the reddish brown precipitate. Hence, the difference or the end point cannot be spotted in the iodine. Moving on to the limitations of Mohr's method. It cannot be carried out in the basic medium because Ag plus ion will precipitate as silver hydroxide. It can also not be carried out in presence of ammonium ion. It cannot be carried out in presence of reducer or reducing agents because CrO4 2- will be reduced to Cr3+. It cannot be done in presence of ions like PO4 3-, S2-, etc. because it will give painted precipitate. So, this was all about Mohr's method. Consider subscribing my channel if you like this video. Do share with your friends and visit my channel for more. Thank you for watching.